Hi guys, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this lesson, let's learn about slash chords and how you can use them to make the triads you already know, be it major or minor, sound a lot more interesting, have a lot of purpose, and tell better stories. In this lesson, we are going to look at the D major scale and just use chords within that scale. So let's build the scale together first of all. D major, F sharp and C sharp, isn't it? Two sharps, F sharp and C sharp. Now we are going to play some chords, and the chords are just going to be the one chord, the four chord, the one chord again, and then the five chord. That's the chord progression. So what is the one chord? The chord built out of the first note or the root note, D. The four chord, G. The one chord, D. And the five chord A, and that's pretty much it. So before we get started with the usage of slash chords, if you guys haven't already, please subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon for notifications whenever we release a new video. Let's begin. So the whole idea of using slash chords is to change the bass note of the chord, right? So you need to focus a lot on this hand, on the left hand, for this exercise. In order to do that, I guess your subconscious mind needs to really get done and dusted and bank on the right hand to deliver. So for that, you can use the appropriate chord inversions to shift between the chords easily. So D major, for instance, the first chord of the D major scale, D major, can be played either as D F sharp A, F sharp A D, or A D F sharp. All these three options exist. Similarly, the G chord, G, B, D, B, D, G, D, G, P. And in all these instances, I'm just playing the true root or the root note of the chord or the name of the chord in the bass hand or the left hand. Last chord for the exercise, A major, A, C sharp, E, A, E, A, C sharp. Now, why do you need to know so many positions or so many shapes? Really helpful, so that you can shift well between them. So if you start with, let's say, A, D, F sharp, which is the second inversion of D major, you can so easily glide to A major, almost blindly, right? See, I'm able to do this just by looking at you guys. So A, D, F sharp, A, C sharp, E. So you do 1, 4, back to D major, G major, which is BDG, BDG, ADF sharp, AC sharp, E. So I'd advise you to practice this on different starting positions. ADF sharp, then you could start with DF sharp A, which is DF sharp A, DGB, DF sharp A, C sharp E, A. And then you could start with F sharp AD, which is the first inversion. F sharp AD, GBD, F sharp AD, E, A, C sharp. There we go. So either of those ways of playing it could work for you, depending on what vibe you want. But the actual vibe is created in the left hand. So if I played all these chords with their root or their bass note, all chords feel very stable, right? Also sort of feels like the person who you're writing the story about, like, or the lead actor or the hero, sort of not doing much, just in the house, just chilling out on a sofa or something. Now, if you want to make it come to life or tell us a story, what I really like is to use slash chords. So a slash chord is a normal triad, like a D major chord, with a bass which is not the name of the chord, or which is not the root of the chord. So if I take D major, normally you would be playing D. That creates a very stable, resolved kind of a bass, right? Something complete. But now if I change the note, it's going to create a rather different sensation. And how do I change it? Well, you could change it by adding a variety of bass notes, but in this lesson I'm going to focus on adding the other chord tones, which are nothing but the third, D's third, D major is what now? F sharp, isn't it? F sharp, or you can even add the fifth, which is A. And what's going to happen is we are going to play that down below in the bottom. So the sound is going to be built from a note, which is not the root. So if I take D major with F sharp bass, right, I'm sure you feel this, right? It just doesn't sound very stable. This is like you've come back home. You've relaxed. While the chord with a different bass note just feels like it's yearning for something more. You know, it's asking a question, where do I go next? And it's a great way to kind of tell a story. All stories have a journey which you try to set up. So this particular chord, D with F sharp bass, seems to want to go to the G. For some reason, the G, even though it's not the root chord of the D major scale, feels a lot more homely than the D with F sharp bass, you know. So D with F sharp is what you could say is an anticipation. It's anticipating to G. Okay. You may ask why. You can observe the semitone or the steps between the notes. If you take the closed step, which is F sharp going to G, it sort of creates a nice magnetic locking effect. So actually, if you play it up top, you can really hear it well, and it serves as great voice leading. But now we are also reinforcing it in the left. So I'd also advise you to sing these moving notes to connect the chord, so your ears also get a lot stronger. So you could go, maybe lower, maybe even lower. I quite like that. So just get acquainted with F sharp going to G, which is that half step which creates that magnet, okay? And the remainder of the chord progression will have you playing D with another bass, which is its fifth. What is D's fifth again? A. So D, the fifth or the third note of the chord. So again, if I play D forward slash A, which is another slash chord, again, it's like, yeah, this is wanting to go somewhere. And it obviously should kind of want to go to the fifth, because the fifth note of the scale, A, is already in the bass. So if you play A major after that, it sort of completes the puzzle, you know. Or you reach a conclusion. So the whole chord progression again, D with F sharp bass, G major normal, D with A bass, A normal. So you create the sense of tension, resolution, again tension, resolution, and then the ultimate resolution, which is D forward slash D, which is just written as D, D major. Okay, so I hope you guys have followed that so far, and I also hope that you follow the purpose of slash chords. It's not just something you can stick in and do for fun. It's something you do so that you're creating this nice embedded emotion of tension following resolution, which is how most stories want to be told in any case, right? Then you enjoy it. It becomes entertaining, right? In all of our opinions, I'm sure. So let's go through this one more time just so that we haven't forgotten anything. The chord progression is the 1-4-1-5. Play that really well. Get your right hand to be absolutely subconscious. And then in our bass hand, we are trying to not play the true roots of the chords, namely D, G, D, A. We are messing with the one chord, which is the D in this lesson. So the one first goes to the D with F sharp bass, which is its third, yearning to go to G. Then D with A, which is its fifth bass, yearning to go to 5. Create a nice loop of this. And to close the job, don't forget to make some music around this. So use your voice and sing a melody and just see where it takes you. I'm quite certain that this will really help guide your story, you know, or point you in a direction where you want to go as a songwriter. So, see how I'm able to sing, and it creates a nice connection. And as always, also practice the bass of the chord. So hope you guys have understood this lesson, and I hope you can use this in your music. And if you have made some music, or if you do make some music with this, do share it with us without fail, right? So as always, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Turn on the bell icon for notifications, and please share the YouTube video with all of your musician friends out there. Cheers.